This is a video response to Randall, Shadrach, Potate. The poor dad just wants the best for his son. I think all dads do. You asked the question, brother. And like Work Clock Orange, or Orange, where I never can remember the way those go, sorry, said in his video response, we may never know the answer. And if we do, it may never get published, because I don't know, medicine and the pharmaceutical companies, they know that when you cure something, you hurt business. So when's the last time a cure has been found? Last thing I can think of is polio back in the 50s. Since then, we only maintain illnesses. You know, cancer, things like that. It's everything's profit-driven. But okay, well, I won't get on that kick, because that's a big, you know, conspiracy kick, and I don't want to bog this down that way. I want to give support to Randall and any other parents of children with autism. Man, studies, a lot of studies have been done, and they just don't seem to be able to find the exact cause. Lots of different factors. I'll hypothesize with everybody else. What do I think it is? For the longest time, most kids in the U.S. don't eat real food. They eat fake food. It's more chemical than it is actual natural food. Drink sodas instead of juices or water. They eat just junk. I mean, I go to schools every day. Amber can testify to this. Our kids at daycares get several snacks throughout the day. And it's not usually snacks on an apple or some carrots or a banana. No, these snacks are cookies and what else did I see that was not candy bars, but just like marshmallows and you know, the pretzels and just salt and sugar and processed crap. That's a whole nother rant about the way we overfeed children. We really do. Now, is it the bad food we eat? Or is it the vaccinations? That's another theory, is about the vaccinations. The problem I have with it being vaccinations is, how does that explain the majority of kids that get vaccinated who have no problems with autism or anything like that? That seems to be an inconsistency there. Now, it may be such a thing that the amount of vaccinations given in a short period of time could have something to do with it, but like, you know, I'm guessing, as you know, many of us are here on YouTube. We're all guessing, but we're just going by the research. And then I saw somebody else who said it was hereditary, or it's in the genes. You're born with it. Could be. Definitely, it's not certain that we're born with it. Okay, I know we're not certain about that, but that is another possibility. So we've got all these different variables. So finding it, the problem, the actual problem, becomes more and more difficult because of so many variables. Another variable, we're diagnosing it more, you know, than we ever used to. We diagnose a lot of things now that people just used to deal with back when, but now we have a name and a diagnosis for everything from blinking too much to restless leg syndrome. Hearing. I'm not equating autism with restless leg syndrome or anything like that. I'm just saying that we are much more aware and keen on things. The best I can find out about it is, I don't know. and a lot of people don't know. Randall, hang in there, brother. You know we're all with you and wish we could do something. Just hug Tucker. He's a good boy.